Hello students, I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to start chapter 5, solids, liquids and gases. Now first we will discuss about matter. We see different things in our surrounding. For example, chair, table, book, water, air, everything in our surrounding. It can be solid, it can be liquid, and it can be gas also. And these things, they have different shape, they have different color, they have different size. But all these things, they occupy space and they also have mass. So we can say anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. It can be solid, it can be liquid, and it can be gas also. And matter is made up of tiny particles called molecules. And these molecules, they cannot be seen with naked eyes. They can only be seen with the help of a microscope. Why? Because these are very small particles. And every matter is made up of a particular type of molecule. For example, water. Water is liquid, but it is also a matter. Why? Because it occupies space and it also has some mass. And this is also made up of tiny particle called molecule. So water is made up of water molecule. Similarly, sugar. Sugar is made up of sugar molecule. So we can say every matter is made up of different molecules. Now next is states of matter. There are mainly three states of matter: solid, liquid and gases. So matter can be in three forms. It can be in solid form, it can be in liquid form and it can also be in gases form. Now first we will discuss about solids. Solids are generally hard. For example, if we take example of a table or a chair, this is a solid and it has definite shape and definite volume. So we can say solids have definite shape and definite volume. Why? Because the molecules in solids are closely packed, tightly packed, and they cannot move and they have strong force of attraction between them. So we can say solid molecules, they are not free to move. So that's why solids have definite shape and definite volume. Now second state of matter is liquid. For example, water, milk, juices, all these are liquids. And these liquids have definite volume, but they do not have definite shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are kept, right? And these liquids can flow easily. Why these liquids can flow easily? Because the molecules in liquids are less closely packed than solids. And these molecules, they can move here and there. And this is the reason the liquids can flow easily. And liquids, they do not have definite shape because these molecules keep on moving here and there. And that's why they do not have fixed shape. But they have fixed volume. They have definite volume. We can measure them. Now next we will discuss about gases. Gases have no definite shape and no definite volume. They can flow more easily than liquids. Why they can flow more easily than liquids? Because the molecules in gases are very loosely packed and they are free to move here and there. And there is very weak force of attraction between them. Okay. And example of gases are oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen. Okay. All these are examples of gases. So we can say gases do not have definite shape and they do not have definite volume. And they flow more easily than liquids. Now let us try to understand difference between solids, liquids and gases on the basis of some points. So first we will discuss about shape. Solids have definite shape. Liquids, they do not have definite shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are kept. And gases also do not have definite shape. Next is volume. Solids have definite volume. Liquids have definite volume. And gases do not have definite volume. Now, next is hardness. Solids are generally hard. Liquids are not hard. And gases are also not hard. Then last point is flow. Solids can not flow, liquids they can flow, and gases also they can flow. So liquids and gases they both can flow, and they are also called fluids. Now next is states of water are interchangeable. You all must have seen that water can be converted into solid form, that is ice. How? By keeping it in refrigerator, or by cooling it or freezing it. And the same water can also be converted into steam or in gaseous form by boiling. Okay, so we can say water can be changed into different states. Water is already in liquid form. It can be changed into solid form, means ice, and it can also be converted into gaseous form, means steam. Okay, so in this we will discuss how we can convert states of water. Now, if we take solid or ice, and if we want to convert ice into liquid, then we can keep it outside the refrigerator, or when we give heat to ice, then it will start melting. So by melting, we can convert solid into liquid, means ice into water. And this water can be converted into gaseous form with the help of boiling. When we boil water, then it start forming steam. And that steam again can be converted into water by cooling, which is called condensation. And this liquid, means water, can be converted into ice by freezing. So we can say we can change all the states of water by heating or by cooling. Okay, so this way we can say states of water are interchangeable. We can convert it into solid, or we can convert it into liquid, or it can be also converted into gases. Now, next we will discuss that what happens when solids dissolve in liquids. We know that some solids can be dissolved in liquids, like sugar and salt. If you try to dissolve these things, you can easily dissolve them in liquids or in water. So, what happens in this case? When solids dissolve in liquids, the molecules of solids fill the empty spaces among the molecules of water. So the water level in the glass remains the same. That is, the volume of water does not change. For example, sugar and water. Now let us try to understand this with the help of this diagram. These red color molecules are the molecules of sugar, and these blue color molecules are the molecules of water. When we mix sugar and water, then these red color molecules, means molecules of sugar, will occupy the space in between the molecules of water. As you can see in this picture, blue color molecules are getting mixed with red color molecules. Here, red color molecules are sugar molecules, and blue color molecules are water molecules. So, here, all these molecules are getting mixed. And red color molecules, means sugar molecules, they are taking place in between the empty spaces between the water molecules. So in this way, the water level will remain same, means the volume of water does not change. It will remain same. So next we will discuss solute. The substances that dissolve in a liquid are said to be soluble in that liquid, and these are called solutes. For example, sugar and salt. As we have already discussed that sugar gets dissolved in water, so we can say here sugar is solute. And if we dissolve salt in water, so here salt will be solute. Next is solvent. The liquid in which a substance or solute dissolves is called a solvent. As we have already discussed that sugar dissolves in water, so here sugar is solute and water is solvent. So the liquid in which we dissolve any substance or in which we dissolve a solute, then that liquid is called a solvent. If we are dissolving sugar in milk, then here milk will be the solvent. Now next is solution. The liquid that we get by dissolving a solute in a solvent is called a solution. For example, sugar solution. Just now we have discussed that solute plus solvent will give solution. Here sugar will be solute, water will be solvent, and we will mix both solute and solvent, then we will get solution. We will get sugar solution. So solute and solvent both mixes together to give solution. Now next we will discuss that how gases can also be dissolved in water or liquids. You all must have observed cold drink bottles. When you open cold drink bottles or soft drinks, then you see gas escaping out or bubbles of gas escaping out. So these are the bubbles of carbon dioxide gas which is filled in these drinks. Okay, so we can say gases can also be dissolved in liquids. Another example is when we see aquatic plants and animals. We know that aquatic plants and animals, they live in water and they breathe in water only. So they breathe oxygen which is already dissolved in water. So they take in oxygen and give carbon dioxide in water only. So we can say gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen, these gases can also be dissolved in liquids.